held on to it. There was a period also when we first came here, which is in the 60s, late 60s, where Swiss Germans would speak English or French to each other. And frequently they don't come from the same village, so they do have a different dialect, and so why not speak the other language? But then they went, even a rather modern kind of ethnic pride came back, so you hear lots more of it. And then we're about 18 to 20% speaking French here. That's Geneva, Neuchâtel, Fribourg, what have I left out, the Valais. And then Vaud, obviously, where Lausanne is. And then 7% is Italian. And then there's this funny language called Romanche, which is a Latin, a derivation of Latin, spoken up in some mountain valleys up towards St. Moritz, the eastern end. And eastern, southern, as to say, towards Italy. But they're dead-ended valleys, so there wasn't a lot of passage of people, and as a result, the language didn't evolve. But they can't go to school in that language past eighth grade, so they either make a choice or they stay on the farm. And you don't hear it very often, but there're not that many thousand of them, but they are linguists. If they usually grow up, they usually speak three, four, five languages. But they must go to Italian or German, usually go on in school. So that's when you hear Switzerland has three languages. Sometimes you'll hear some people say it has four. But that four national, this is picky. Four national languages, three official.
There you go. Very tactical.
Yeah. So anyway, that's explaining a lot more to me. Anyway, what else should we say about here? If you don't have a stiff neck like I do, up by the arch, there's two people playing trumpets facing each other. Those are original. The rest of it is copies.